Let's see another Hausung principle that will help to enhance your animations. Arcs, the invisible lines created by objects or body parts moving. This is the path of the motion. Any movement we create has its own path. In making it smooth and curved, it helps to make your animation more realistic and fluid first, but also more nice and harmonic to watch. You should never forget while you are animating, most of your movements should have smooth and circular arc. We should visualize and adjust this path for the big movements, such as an arm gesture with a simple circular arc, or we should follow a rounded path during more complex movements. A classic arc during a jump, a kick, a throw. But we should check the arcs even in that little movements that maybe we can forget. A head turn creates an arc, a mouth opening, a change in weight. For all these situations, you should keep attention to the visual path created by the movement and adjust it until you don't reach a nice result. A circular and smooth path is what you usually find in reality and everything results more fluid and natural. This requires to create good breakdowns in your blocking and a particular attention during the polishing of your animation. You should check if on each frame your movement well follows the arc you want. In 3D, we can have different tools to help us to check the arcs, from the tool that you have in Maya, the visualization of the motion trails. This tool is very fast to use and I explain it in the tutorial 7, how to refine a shot, but you can also install some scripts to show your path or use some other extra softwares that allow you to draw on your screen and create your arc or manually do it using a transparent paper on your screen. Find your best method to do this delicate path of polishing. The time you will spend during this process, it really worth it. Let's see other example analyzing different actions. In a walk, we should have a smooth arc for the head and the hip with their movement up and down. The arms swinging usually creating a figure eight arc. The feet that moves up and down and back and forth creating a circular arc when they are in the air and a straight line during the contact. A big leg movement could create this arc. Small rotation movements would have a small circle path. Even the eyes moving arc. When you change the focus, so when you move the eyes position, it will be a very fast movement, usually a maximum of 2-3 frames. The pose in the middle should be positioned in order to smooth the arc. During an acting where the arms will do a lot of gestures, each gesture should have a nice path, but it's important to add variations in the arc shapes and amplitude of the gesture, especially if we have different movements in few frames. During a wow exclamation, we can play with the arcs to give more flexibility to the mouth and the face and make it more appealing. The opening movement should move up and down and from right to left to create this effect. Also, inanimate objects move, creating arcs. A character on a swing has different arcs for the swing seat, the feet, and the head. A ball bouncing on a character's hand creates circular arcs. There are some particular cases where we need straight path and not an arc. This happens with mechanical movements or to give a super fast and powerful energy to a moving object, like in this example with a more powerful kick that will have a more straight line compared to the more soft one. I really hope you now apply this principle to your animation so that you will see how important arcs are. See you for the next lesson on Post the Pose and Straight Ahead.